हरि ओम। वामशी भगवद गीता, रिस्क्रिप्टिंग द भगवद गीता टेक्स्ट फॉर बिगिनर्स। वी हैव सीन दैट मेनी पीपल फ्रॉम ऑल सेक्शंस ऑफ सोसाइटी, इररेस्पेक्टिव ऑफ देयर क्लास, क्रीड, बैकग्राउंड, रिलीजन डिफरेंसेस, लैंग्वेज, अपब्रिंगिंग, आर थर्स्टिंग टू लर्न द भगवद गीता, बट दे जनरली स्ट्रगल विद द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ मिसप्रोनाउंसिएशन और द फियर ऑफ इट. Hence, many refrain from even making the effort. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita, that is BG, being a Smriti text, a text derived in the spirit of the Vedas, a text worthy of committing to memory, a text that breathes life into people's spiritual world, a text that is one among the Prasthanatraya, a text that is magical in its sounds, a simple eloquent text which marries spiritualism with materialism, is worth rescripting so that it reaches the masses. A style which simplified this problem and hopefully came as a solution by taking inspiration from the Vedic style of recitation and with some applicable grammar rules, a new style was concocted with the grace of the Guru. Having tested this method on a few subjects, the results suggested that it caters easily to all Devanagari script knowers who could immaculately recite it at the first and in a few cases the second try. Hence, this method, with the sole goodwill to help people with such proper recitation, was to expand and reach out to those interested. I gratefully acknowledge the efforts of Darshana in meticulously typing many of the adhyayas and for scrutinizing it in order to uphold the integrity of the style. May Shri Bhagavan bless us and lead us to light. Here are some of the conventions and rules followed to derive the Vamshi style. Syllables up to a maximum of 3 and rarely 4 are used. Parasavarna Sandhi, Visarga, Shtutva, Sattva and other such sandhis are operated everywhere possible except if it is violated in the original itself. Otherwise, in Sanyasam Karmanang Krishna becomes Sanyasam Karmanang Krishna. And we have used the Manisraj style, that is pronouncing a shloka as a quartet. Except where there is a necessity to preserve the chandas or if it's a fully compounded word. For example, in 6.9, Suhrin Mitraryudasina Madhyasthadveshya Bandhushu is two of the quartets combined together because it is a compound word. And in 8.20, Parastasmattu bhavonyo vyakto vyaktat sanatanaha, where the original itself has the avagraha, that is a, as avyakto avyaktat sanatanaha, when it combines by doing the sandhi, the two quarters integrate into one. And the all the compounds are broken down into easily readable but not necessarily meaningful, simpler comprising words. For example, Mano Ratha is written as Mano and Ratha. Brahma Nirvanam is written as Brahma Nirvanam. The following conjunct letter is adopted by the previous word. For example, Ajnyascha Shraddhanascha becomes Ajnyascha Shraddhanascha. Again, Kshetra Kshetrajna Sanyogat becomes Kshetra Kshetrajna Sanyogat. The splitting is based on the ease of reading and complying with the other rules here. As far as possible, when a swara is preceded by a vyanjana, samhita, that is simple joining to make a gunitakshara, is done. Hence, even in splitting, the same rule applies. For example, Senayorubhayor madhye is split as Senayorubhayor madhye instead of Senayor उभयोर मध्ये यू सी द व्यंजनाय इज फॉलोड बाय अस्वरा दैट इज उ सो वी कंबाइन इट यूजिंग संहिता एवरीवेयर इन दिस स्टाइल द एम्फसिस इज लेड ऑन द प्रोनाउंसिएशन ओनली एंड नेवर ऑन द मीनिंग सो नो अटेम्प्ट्स टू डिसाइफर और इंटरप्रेट द मीनिंग should be made with respect to the shlokas written in this style. We believe that Sanskritam being a phonetic language and with sound therapy re-emerging and with the proof of the strength of vibrations of Sanskritam words, the correct pronunciation of the Bhagavad Gita shlokas can propel people out of their miseries and enhance their spiritual growth. The meanings, however, should be learned from other sources such as from Gita Press editions, Bhashyas and etc. This style should be practiced well and up to the point where the flow of words becomes uninterrupted. The split words must come together in the holy union by the glue of practice until the breaks disappear altogether. Recitation of the split words with pauses is acceptable only as beginners, but it must be taken to completion when the words come out gently and fluently. Usage of this style to diminish or denigrate the BG or to color it as such an attempt is highly condemnable. This is to be used only after a certain maturity and when the words have sunk in. Using it for parayanas at the amateur level is strictly discouraged. Here is the introduction, a brief introduction to Devanagari script. These are the swaras. Vowels a a I I u u r r u a i o au. These are the vyanjanas, consonants ka kha ga gha nga cha cha ja jha nya ta tha da dha na ta tha da dha na pa pha ba bha ma ya ra la va sha sha sa ha. La also appears in the script, however this is not existent in the Bhagavad Gita. Gunitakshara means vyanjana with a swara. K a becomes ka, k e becomes ki, h a becomes he, and any consonant that is vyanjana can go with any swara. So here we have written for one consonant with all the swaras. G a becomes ga, ga, gi, gi, gu, gu, gr, gr, gl, ge, gai, go, go. Conjuncts or Sanyuktakshara is when a vyanjana occurs with a vyanjana. So k sh becomes ksh, tr, tr, shr, shr, jnya, 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 dya, dya. This symbol, the half dash below, called the halanta symbol, represents the vyanjana alone, that is the half syllable consonant. Ayogavaha, the visarga with two dots, is called the visarga. The convention followed in this style is that the visarga is pronounced with the h and the closest relative of the vowel preceding it. For example, ja and the two dots means ja with the visarga, ja with a, the swara a, and then with the visarga is pronounced as j a ha, j a, then we use ha. With ha we use the preceding swara which is a again, so it becomes j a ha, jaha.
Hari Om. In the previous slide I have a question.
Yes.
If it is j and a,
yes,
then is there any difference in the pronunciation of the visarga?
Yeah, yes, there is no difference in the pronunciation of the visarga because the visarga first of all comes with ha and then the closest relative of the vowel. What does this closest relative mean? The closest relative sometimes is the hrasva form of the swara. So in swaras we have two types, that is the hrasva and the dirgha. In the case that it is ja and then the visarga, ha comes again with the visarga, and then the closest relative of a, which is the vowel preceding the visarga, is the hrasva form, that is a. So it is ja ha, it is not ja ha, Okay, that's a good point to note. It is
so.
Yes.
Sorry, if you pronounce it as a Jaha, then it is wrong, is it?
Yes, if you pronounce it as Jaha, it is wrong. It is Jaha. Atmajaha.
Thank you.
And for these swaras also, there is a peculiarity here. Now, this is I. The swara is I. The swara I, when it is followed by the visarga, does not become I hai. Okay? It becomes I and H. H-I-he. The closest relative of I for the visarga is E. So it is I-h-e. I-he. Putraihi. Similarly with au, the closest relative becomes u for the visarga. So it is au and then visarga becomes au-h-u. Au-hu. Au-hu. Gau-hu. Nau-hu. And so on. However, for the O and the A, the relative is the shortened form of O. For example, O and then visarga becomes O, H, O. O, H. O, H. It is not O, H. It is O, H. Similarly with A. A, H. A, H. Hare, H. Okay? A is followed by the shortened form of A, which is A. A, he. And this is a very special pronunciation where the visarga is preceded by the swara R. For example, matrh, matrh. There is no relative of R, the swara R for the visarga. Hence, it is just left as H, the vyanjana H itself. So it becomes ma, matrh. R, H, R, H. Okay. Coming to the anuswara. Yes.
Hari Om.
Yes.
If this comes at the end of a padam,
yes,
then can it be elongated?
If the visarga comes at the end of the padam, I hope it should not be elongated because it may change in chandas. But if it is at the end of the padam, you may try to do so. But I generally recommend to do that.
Thank you.
Especially for these aksharas where the relative is itself the shortened form, it is not advised that you elongate it. For the A case, you might, but for these cases, for I, O, au, O, and A, and then with R, it shouldn't be elongated. Now, with the anuswara, the convention followed here is that the one dot above is called the anuswara, is pronounced as M, that's the vyanjana M. Here, it occurs after a vowel and before either R, Sh, Sh, S, or H. The anuswara is preserved in these cases where it occurs after a vowel and before these five, any of these five consonants. R, Sh, Sh, S, and H. Now we have another character called the Upadhmaniya. Upadhmaniya. Now the convention used here is, it is pronounced as F, as in flower. The F in flower is the Upadhmaniya. It occurs when a visarga precedes P or P. So when there's a visarga followed by P or P, the visarga changes into the Upadhmaniya, which is the F. Yaha phalanirya. Yaf phalanirya. Yaf F. As you blow the air out of over your lips, that is the F. The last character is Jihwa Mooliya. Now this convention used here is the percentage symbol. It is pronounced as Akh, Akh. As you cough, that sound that emerges from the throat, where the tongue emerges, where the tongue is born, that is called the Jihwa Mooliya. Akh. So you have मित्रह खगे मित्रह खगे मित्रह अह मित्रह खगे द विसर्ग चेंजेस इनटू द जिह्वा मूलिया बिफोर क और ख इट बिकम्स अह नाउ हियर आर सम ऑफ द सेमी वोवेल्स दीज आर थ्री इन नंबर अन्य ल व विद द नेसलाइज्ड साउंड so which is the nasalized anuswara along with the ya la va consonants respectively as in when you say the word sanyukta okay sanyukta it is not sayayukta it is sai there is only one ya with the swara u so you shouldn't say sayayukta it is sanyukta Now, avagraha, which is represented by any of these three symbols, does not have any special pronunciation, but in grammar, it is only presence of Some people would like to elongate the vowel preceding it. Here, we have not done that. The convention here for these cases are if ha is followed by ma it is pronounced as mha like brahma okay it is not brahma although some people would like to call that but here the convention we have followed is brahma with less emphasis on the ha so it is brahma somehow like the double m or a single m Similarly with vanhi also the na will come first and ha later vanha okay grinhati similarly it is first the na and then the ha grinhati now these are the only exceptions where the interchanging of the pronunciation happens in sanskritam everywhere else the first letter is pronounced first And the second letter is pronounced later. So as is written, so is spelled. So is pronounced and so is meant. Whichever consonant occurs first in the conjunct, that is pronounced first as a half syllable. The priority goes as this: first the top consonant is pronounced, and then the bottom, then left to right. For example, in the r, in the artha is read as first a. And then you have a top consonant, so that is read first. A, R. Then bottom, you come to the bottom aksharas. So it is ta, ta. Okay, so ta is left. So you read it from left to right. So A, R, T, A, R, ta. Okay. Similarly with kartsnyam, how is it read? There is no top akshara, so you just go from left to right. K, A. Now what do you encounter next? T. Is that so? No, because you have to read it from top to bottom first. Check if there's anything in the top. There is. It is r. So take that first. So k a and then you take the r. Then you go to the below aksharas. It starts left with t, then s, then n, y, a, and then m. So it is read as k a r t s n y m. Kartsnyam okay the text has 700 shlokas the majority of them around 650 shlokas are in the anushtup chandas so it is advised that all such shlokas are sung in the same tune because generally people would like to sing as in a particular chandas in the same tune a few shlokas that is approximately 50 are in other meters those meters are denoted As and when we encounter them, Upendra Vajra is written as U, Indra Vajra E, Upajata as UI, and then Trishthub is T. They are sung separately in other such tunes. There are several places where the original text of BG, that is Bhagavad Gita itself, has broken a few meters, and also at a few places it transgresses the syntactical boundaries of Paninian grammar. Because this text, Bhagavad Gita, was pre-Paninian, so there are some places where we may find exceptions and transgressions. It is not to be perceived as a mistake in the Vamshi style also. After using the style Vamshi for beginner's purposes, the shlokas must be recited as a congruent whole. The shlokas, that is the quartets, also called the Manisraj style, are to be recited independently as four lines. That is what the Manisraj style demands. Full visarga uchcharana occurs before the ksha, the samyukta akshara ksha. For example, samadukha sukha kshami, because visarga is followed by ksha. So the full uchcharana, that is, as you would pronounce the visarga at the end of a pada, is to be pronounced here. Samadukha sukha kshami. The visarga in the words like dukha and at the end of sentences are left as it is. Parasavarna sandhi are possible. Now these are some of the fundamental guidelines to the script. Detailed description is to be obtained from elsewhere and fully internalized. That is the detailed description of the Devanagari script. For example, the half conjunct representations of yanchanas are gra. Now this symbol is g and ra. Gra. This is dhya, rga, rti, nya. Now these are to be known only through practice and by thoroughly going through the Devanagari script. Now this style is only for those who are well versed with the Devanagari script. Now this is to be understood that every canto begins with the header Om Shri Paramatmane Namaha Atha, and whichever adhyaya is being studied, that is the ordinal number in Sanskritam, like Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, and so on up to Ashtadasha dash Yoga. Every canto has a particular name, and so you say that name with Yogaha. And the footer for every canto is Om Tat Saditi, Om Tat Saditi, Tat Saditi. Srimad Bhagavad Gitasu, Upanishatsu, Brahma Vidyayam, Yoga Shastre, Shri Krishna Arjuna Samvade. Again, you repeat the name of the canto, dash Yogo Nama, and then the number, the canto's number, dash Adhyaya, Prathamo Adhyaya, Dvitiyo Adhyaya, and other, so on. Now, every shloka is numbered. If you find this abbreviation Shri U, it means Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, that is Shri Krishna spoke these verses. If you find the abbreviation A-U, it means Arjuna Uvacha, that is Arjuna spoke. And seldom you find Sa-U, it means Sanjaya Uvacha, that is Sanjaya spoke these verses. Now these are some of these guidelines to Vamshi. You can find the 16th Adhyaya chanted in this Vamshi style for practice to get familiarized with how these words are split and how these verses are to be memorized. In another playlist, I will have posted all the 18 Adhyayas in the Vamshi style. You may also find the PDF version of the entire Bhagavad Gita in the Vamshi style on our website, Samskriti Nandini website, whose link is also provided in the description below. Dhanyavadaha.